because today's a new episode of Notes from My Improv Notebook. Hi, everybody, and welcome back to Notes from My Improv Notebook. This is Xchel Hernandez, your host. It's just me this week, which is sad because I did like having Jackie around. But I am reaching out to other people, so hopefully you will have a different perspective on improv comedy. Improv is a great art form, and there are just so many different ways to approach it. I'm sure that you guys have a few things that have really related to you that you've accumulated from different teachers. You might see me at shows around town. Specifically, I'm at Second City, where this week I will be at the LA Diversity Festival. So if you want to stop by and check me out, I'm performing with a great group of mine called Geraldo. We do improv all in Spanish. It's a lot of fun because it shows that humor is its own language and it does not have the bounds of English or Spanish or any other language. There are funny things to be seen out there. Guys, if you haven't already, please rate and review my podcast. I would really appreciate that. Every rate and review actually helps me by getting it to different people that actually might get help from this podcast. So I would really appreciate if you took the time to just press pause on the podcast, hit 5 stars on the podcast, and leave a little rate. And I'll actually read them. I've actually have 2 reviews. The first one is from Anthony Says, and he says, "Oh my God, it's the best" by Not Xchel. So this is Anthony Says, and he says, "Oh my God, so good. I hope Xchel knows that he's so cool. He's totally not reviewing his own podcast." And that was left by Not Xchel. That's how he signed off. So that was really nice of him to leave that podcast review. I have another one too. This is from Nancy Kingdon. Nancy Kingdon says, "My new favorite podcast. This podcast is awesome. Xchel is so insightful and passionate about improv and his creativity. I can't wait for more episodes." Of course, Notes from My Improv Notebook is your internet's free resource for improv instruction. So thank you so much for tuning in, and let's get into it. Today, I want to actually talk about auditioning and how to combat those nerves when you are auditioning. I hate auditioning. I'm the first one to tell you. Auditioning is one of those things where if I had to go on a healthy diet for a year or go to an audition, I'd pick the healthy diet for a year. In all honesty, audition forces us to be very cognizant of what we're doing. And that could be so anti-improv, you know, because in improv, you're really trying to do a free flow type of moment where you're not thinking, you're not judging yourself. But when you're in an auditioning environment, you find yourself judging yourself at every move that you make. Like, did I just say hi the wrong way to this person that I just met? Do I not tag in first because then everyone will think I'm the jerk? I've had all these thoughts. I'm very fortunate that I've been through a lot of auditions. I started doing theater back when I was in middle school and then improv around when I was 21. So I've been in the constant state of auditioning. But I can tell you that auditioning just never changes. It's always the same. Am I good enough feeling? Am I good enough nervousness? I think it's difficult for me to treat auditions because I'm always trying to make sure the person across from me is having a lot of fun. And then I just get self-conscious and think, am I being too helpful? Is he think I'm just being mean to him? Like, am I being like passive aggressive? When in all honesty, I just want us all to have a good time. I've been very fortunate that here in Los Angeles, there have been classes that you actually have to audition for. What they're actually teaching you is that audition is a skill, and it's totally different from actually performing at your greatest strengths. That's something that we need to keep in mind when we are out there, is that if we're auditioning, it's a totally different skill. You know, you're combating nerves. You're trying to impress people. In Los Angeles, we have classes out here that we actually have to audition for. We have to audition for Second City Hollywood. We had to audition for Groundlings. Auditions are tough, you know. You're always putting yourself in like this weird mental place where you don't believe that you can actually succeed. And you end up walking away like, what's the point? If I can't audition, what's the point of me continuing? I just want to let you know that everyone feels this way. I understand that auditioning is a part of the process, but it could really put us in a bad frame of mind. I really wish there was just an audition just to be like, hey, are you awesome? And everyone who does it's all like, oh yeah, you're awesome. I remember I had to audition for Second City classes. So I didn't know what to expect. But really what they were teaching us was the skill to audition, how to be confident in whatever move you make, and to not let fear take you over. Because essentially when people audition you, they just want to see how you react under pressure, how you're able to combat that negative voice in the back of your head. And he sits in the back of your head, and every time you say yes and, he's all like, you said the yes and to the wrong thing. You're dumb. When I first moved out to Los Angeles, I did the audition over at Second City. It went all right, but I remember walking away being like, I'm not going to get it. I'm horrible at this. I don't know what I'm doing here. You end up putting a lot of pressure on yourself when you audition. There's a lot of nervous energy that you're actually going through. It's coming from a place of, am I good enough? And I just want to say, if you were able to get out of your house, get ready, drive to the audition, complete it, and walk out of there, you did a great job. We need to understand as performers that we are worth it. It's when we doubt ourselves the most is when we find ourselves at our weakest. So I just want you to understand that no matter where place you are when you're heading into an audition, give it your all. Because the worst thing you can do is walk away from an audition saying, I could have done a little bit more. And not all auditions are fair. Sometimes people are looking for not you. First time that I auditioned for a Herald team at Iowa West, I was in classes still and I was really excited. I actually wore a pleather jacket. And I went to the audition and I was so stoked. I felt like everything I was doing was the right move. I was getting a response from the auditioners. I was having fun with my teammates. I walked out of there like I could skate, and I've never skated in my life. Like, you know that feeling when you're so excited, you feel like you could do anything? Like, that's how I felt leaving that audition. And I remember waiting 2 weeks to hear nothing back from them because ultimately it wasn't what they were looking for. That's the tough part. You know, I walked away from there, and my friends were just like, wow, that was amazing. You're totally going to get it. I'm so excited for you. And to feel that confidence of like your friends telling you how great you were, and then just to walk away like you didn't receive anything is kind of a heartbreak, but it's going to happen. I think a lot of the things that we don't expect happen in our lives, you know? It's a way to teach us how to deal with those things. And I'm here to tell you, even though I didn't make it at that audition, at least I didn't walk away saying, I could have done more. I could have committed more to a character. I could have said yes to my partner more. If you walk into audition and you walk out saying, I did everything I could, congratulations. You're really doing it. You're being a great performer. You're being what you were meant to be, what you want to be. Sometimes this journey can be slow. Sometimes you don't understand why is it that you're in a certain level and you don't feel like you're increasing. But in all honesty, you are. Because each of those experiences that you go through makes you a better player. I've had this experience, and I don't know if you have, where if you perform in a certain place that makes you totally nervous, it just wrecks your nerves. You're like, I don't want to go on stage. I'm going to puke. But then you go up there and you do it. You just feel so good afterward because you were able to combat fear. And that's the greatest trait that anyone could ever do. And you have that. You're overcoming your fear. You're not letting it take a hold of you. You're not letting it stop you. You're going there and you're completing a task even though you're afraid. And you find after you experience that, the next time you're on stage, you're like, wow. This isn't as bad as that audition. And you feel freer. You feel like you can do more things. You feel like you could commit to an even higher place. You feel like you could say yes to everything. And that's why I do think that you need to go to auditions. Even if you're not ready for that specific team that you think you want, and you're just like, well, I'm in level one. That's like graduation team over there. Go audition. Get used to that process. Find out what it's like to be totally nervous, but but then to overcome that fear to perform so that you can find out that you are a great performer. Ultimately, what we have in improv is our self-confidence. And we're just learning how to be confident in ourselves so that we can make confident moves on stage. So I just want to give you some techniques to go into an improv audition so that you feel you walk away saying, man, I totally kicked butt. The first thing you need to know is to introduce yourself. And introduce yourself with confidence. I get sweaty hands sometimes, so I don't like to shake people's hands. So what I'll do is I'll hold a bottle of water. And that bottle of water will actually stop me from shaking someone's hand right away. Because I'll say, oh, I was holding a wet bottle of water. Let me wipe it off. And then I'll shake their hand. So if you're confident and you get sweaty hands, that's something to do. The next thing to do is when you're playing, play the basics. Get your who, what, where out there fast and play committed to the characters that you label or that you get labeled by. Because from the other side of the table, they're looking to see how fast you can assimilate and whether you're not going to deny the other person. I think commitment is the best thing you can do, especially if someone else labels you. If you just commit to the highest level that you possibly can, if someone calls you a mom, and you play that mom character to the max of your abilities, congratulations, you did a good job. I think what's hard to understand is that everyone's just as nervous as you, and that sometimes we're all gonna make nervous moves, and sometimes someone's gonna bring up poop Olympics. Hopefully not, I know I won't ever. So what's an exercise to help you combat your nervousness for an audition? If anyone ever asks for a warm-up, say, I wanna play the worst improv scenes. If they ask you how you play that, it's really easy. You invite everyone to do the worst improv scene they've ever done. And these are quick scenes. So you have a director saying scene probably after 3 or 4 lines once the joke is established. What you find is that people are so excited to do the worst improv they've ever done because everyone feels like they're about to do the worst improv they've ever done. This helps people get together and laugh about their nervous energy. It gets them on the same page so that they understand, wow, we all feel this way, but this is a lot of fun to just fail and fail hard and fail on purpose. Everyone watching is actually having a great time because the game of the scene is very simple. You go out there and you make the worst possible moves that you can make. And after the scene has been called by the director, everyone shouts at the same time, that was the worst. And it's a way to invite people to do the moves that they're afraid to do, but in a very fun way. Thanks again for listening to Notes from My Improv Notebook. I'm so appreciative of you and my listens. I'm actually almost at 100 downloads. I'm so stoked. Thank you so much for listening. It means the world to me. If you haven't already, please rate and review the podcast. I really appreciate when you guys do that. I'll read your rates and reviews. Man, whoever that Xchel was, that was the greatest review I ever read. If you would like, I can actually teach you guys. Please reach out to me. I'm at hisilentx@gmail.com or on Instagram at hisilentx. And that's HISILENTX. Not high, as someone else spelled it the other day, HIGH. Not that way. Also, if you have any improv questions, feel free to reach out to me. I'm always available. You can always email me or send me an Instagram comment or message about something improv related. And the reason I ask for that, because discussing improv actually helps me become a better teacher. So at any time you want to reach out, let me know what you're thinking and I'll totally discuss it. Thank you so much and I hope you have a great week. If anybody has any tips on not holding their breath while talking, please message me too. All right, I better go.